Good day. Thank you for attending my presentation. My name is Paweł Malinowski and I will be talking about damage assessment of composite structures. This work was prepared in collaboration with my colleagues, Dr. Soman, Professor Kudela, Professor Wandowski, Mr. Singh and Mr. Balasubramaniam. We all work at the Institute of Fluid Flow Machinery, Polish Academy of Sciences in Gdańsk, Poland. My presentation is structured as follows. First, I will introduce you to the subject, give the motivation, present the guided wave-based method and the electromechanical-based method. At the end, I will summarize my talk on one slide. We are looking for damage identification and assessment methods in order to prevent failures of various structures. Here are some examples of damaged structures such as rail track or broken wind turbine blade, and we'd like to prevent such events due to early detection of damage such as cracks, delaminations, debonds, and so on. Some of the promising methods used for this task are based on guided wave propagation and the electromechanical impedance. The damage assessment falls into the broader scope of so-called structural health monitoring. The structural health monitoring concept uses a network of sensors deployed on a structure. Next, signals from such sensor are gathered, processed, and at the end you would like to know if the structure is safe to use, so-called healthy, or is it unsafe, is damaged and needs repairing. The focus of my talk will be structures made of lightweight materials such as aluminium alloys, CFRP and GFRP composites. During the research, we need to answer few questions that are related to the structures that we are investigating. So, where to place the sensors? How to effectively excite the structure? Or how to take advantage of external excitation such as wind? Or how to process and assess the data in order to get information about the damage presence, its location and also severity. The first method that I would like to introduce is the guided wave-based propagation. Guided waves are the elastic waves that propagate in thin-walled structures. They propagate in multimode nature, so we have so-called antisymmetric modes and symmetric modes that propagate with various velocities in the material, and depending on the frequency we can have more than one mode propagating in a structure. So at the defect location or at the other discontinuities, such waves are scattered and are also reflected and converted to other modes. So in the figure on the left, it is showed how the propagating symmetrical mode A0 is converted to the antisymmetrical A0 mode, both at the damage and also at the edge of a simple square-like structure. In order to inspect structures, various sensor networks and arrays are used. Here are a few examples. The concentrated arrays that work like radars to scan the surrounding area, or there are also distributed networks that are based on placing sensors far away from each other in network nodes to cover large areas. There are various attempts to put such sensors on the surface, like triangular networks or double sensor networks, where in each node there are two sensors placed. Another effective way to sense the elastic wave propagation is the laser vibrometry. In this approach, the laser beam scans the surface of an object and senses the vibration of a surface. In this way, propagating waves are gathered and such signals are processed in order to assess the damage condition of a structure. Having set of registered points, here we have n points gathered as an example, we can visualize the propagation of the wave. Later such results can be processed, it can be represented in the so-called energy representation, and then some discontinuities that were encountered by the wave propagating the structure can be visualized. Here we see few scatterers of a wave present in this example. On the right hand side we have the frequency wave number representation that allows us to see how the wave number and wave phase velocity changes with the frequency in the investigated material. Some other examples of wave propagating in structures. So here we see some interaction of wave with a defect just after the excitation. On the bottom figure the wave propagated for 100 microseconds and was scattered by another defect in the investigated sample. The example on the right shows an aircraft panel with a lot of rivets and a piezoelectric sensor at the center. The result of measurement with the laser vibrometer is shown at the bottom. We can see that the wave propagating in the structure is converting at various locations. These locations are related to the position of the rivets in this aircraft panel. Another example here is shown for a GFRP panel. It's a sandwich structure with a aluminium core and simulated delamination as shown here. And the result is at the bottom. We can see wave scattering at this defect and clear visualization of the position of the damage. The example on the right shows us the GFRP panel with a stiffener. The stiffener was locally debonded to investigate how the wave propagates in such locally debonded structure. The result at the bottom shows that the debonded region acts as a tunnel for the wave and allows wave to pass through to the other side. We also see a rough estimation of the size of this debond where the wave was traveling through this region. The remaining part of the stiffener is reflecting back the wave and stopping its propagation. Coming to signal processing approaches, if we consider sensor networks, the two most popular techniques is ellipsis-based and hyperbola-based. The ellipsis-based method analyzes the time of flight from the actuator to an arbitrary point and to the sensor, while the hyperbola-based method uses actuator and two sensors and analyzes the time difference of arrival at one and second sensor. The results of such methods are shown here that indicate the locations of the defects investigated object. The problem of placing of the sensors is very crucial in our studies. So there are various approaches how to place properly the sensors on a surface of the structure in order to obtain good damage assessment results. Here I would like to show one example how we employed a genetic algorithm in order to deploy sensors on investigated structures. The first academic example is a triangular plate, and the cost function is based on coverage, and the coverage is the coverage parameters are designed especially for the ellipsis based method that was shown before. The optimal placement that was obtained by the algorithm is shown in this figure, and on the right we can see what is the coverage level of the whole area that was investigated. Next, we undertook a more challenging task of sensor placement for a CFRP composite. So here we had the wave propagation that is dependent on the fiber orientation, and we also included a stiffener for in this plate. Here are some results of our studies. So we assumed 72 candidate locations for the sensors, and if we use all of them for localization, the result is shown on top left corner. But we assume that we would like to use less sensors, so we picked 8 as a arbitrary number, and at the bottom we randomly placed these 8 sensors and plotted the coverage. And now, looking at the results of the optimization, we can see that after 5,000 generations, the genetic algorithm gives us such result. But using 10,000 generations, the result is already symmetric, and we have such trapezoidal shapes of the sensor placement on each side of the stiffener. And the coverage obtained with each placement is shown here in the table. So the optimal placement obtained with the genetic algorithm gives very nice result, far better than the random placement. The second method that I would like to present is the electromechanical impedance, where we investigate the electrical parameters as a function of frequency. These electrical parameters are measured at piezoelectric sensors that are bonded to the inspected structure. Here is a GFRP plate instrumented with 4 sensors, and the damage that was introduced here was an impact damage. There were in total 4 impacts, 2 made at the same location, A and A prime. Next there was a B impact and C impact in such sequence. All of these impacts were made with 30 joule energy. Using of the data, we propose to use the principal component analysis, and we also propose 2 approaches. First one, called the classification approach, that we use all the measured data, meaning the reference data for the plate without damage, and later the damage data for the plate after the impacts. The PCA was performed for this data. Later the results were visualized in the new coordinate system defined by the first 2 principal components. In the second approach, we call this novelty detection. At the beginning we used only the reference data that was processed by the PCA, and after having the new coordinate system defined by the PC, we projected on this space the damage cases measured after the impacts, and here we try to differentiate if we can detect the damage. Result of the classification, so we can see that the sensors that are far away from the damage are clustered separately. So this is P1 and P4. The P3 cluster is over here, P2 is over here, and we have one more data point over here that is related to the last impact case. So here the damage to the plate was most severe. So we had 4 impacts, and this is this case showing largest differences. In the second approach, we assume that we have only reference data for the sensor number 4, and we checked if we are able to see any influence of the damage severity here. Our reference was the result with the RMSD index that was fluctuating for all the cases and didn't indicate it even for sensor P2 any influence of the increasing number of impacts. But when we look at the result for after principal component analysis and principal component 1 for sensor 2, we can see an increase in the projection, indicating the change, and that was related to the increase in the severity of the damage to the plate. At this slide, I summarized the research results I was showing previously for your convenience. Thank you for attention.